Hello everyone, my name is Yuval Moro for Mercurius Solutions, and today we are going to perform DLL hijacking attack. In this attack, we are going to use DLL file in order to run CMD commands to get high privilege in the system. Before we are going to start, I will open CMD and show you all the current users in this computer. I will write net user command, and now you can see all the users I got in the system. Here I got administrator, guest, new user 1, Win 7, Windows 7, and Yuval, which is my name. In this attack, we are going to add another user to the user list called hacker, and in addition, we are going to add this hacker user to the administrator's group. So now we can start the attack. Okay, in order to perform the attack, we need some things as requirements. The first thing is Windows machine. Right now I'm using Windows 7 32-bit. The second thing that we need is to use Linux machine in order to compile the DLL file. The third thing is a DLL file in order to perform the attack. I downloaded this file from the internet and I will show you the content of it later. Next, it's Procmon tool. This tool is from Windows sysinternals, and we can use that to see all the active process in the system. And the last thing that we need is any application. I'm going to use Malwarebytes. This is an antivirus application. And I'm going to run with that application my own DLL file. Okay, so let's start. I will open the DLL file to show you its content. You can see that's a simple file. We can see the main code, and inside, there are two commands. The first command runs inside the CMD and using the command netuser to add a new user called hacker with the password lit. And the second command is using the netlocalgroup command in order to add the hacker user that we just added to the administrators. This is the main code. Now you can see up here that I have added two commands for compiling. Because our file is C file, we need to compile it in order to use it as DLL file. The first command is for Windows 64-bit, and the second command is for Windows 32-bit. The next thing that we are going to do is to take this DLL file, C file, and transfer it to my Linux machine. For that, I created sharing folder, and I'm going to use that in order to move my C file to my Linux machine. So let's do that. Let's go to the Linux machine. And now let's open the file. Let's copy it, move it to my current position, and now we can see there is windowsdll.c file. I will go back to my Windows machine and open the DLL file to copy the command for compiling. As I said, I'm using Windows 32-bit, and because of that, I'm going to use the second command, so I just copied it, and let's go back to the Linux machine and paste it here. Okay. We got the command. We can see that the command is using GCC because we are using C file. We run this command on our windows.dll file, and the output name is output.dll. So let's change it to test.dll and let's run the command. Okay, we can now see that our file is ready. Let's move it back to the Windows machine. I will copy it, move it to the sharing folder, and let's go back to the Windows machine and look for it. Okay, we got it here, and I will copy it to my desktop. Okay, so now we are going to use Procmon tool in order to see all the process in our machine. And with that, I'm going to run the malwarebytes setup application to see it inside the Procmon tool. So I will run the Procmon tool now. I can see all the running processes, and I will open malwarebytes now too. Okay, malwarebytes is now running, and we can look for it inside our Procmon tool. So let's search for that. Okay, here we can see that I have found the malwarebytes setup process inside the Procmon tool. In order to filter that process from all the other processes, I'm going to use the filter feature. So inside, I'm going to choose process name, as we got here, and is malwarebytes setup.exe. I'm going to choose include and click on add, and now I will click on apply and let's check what just happened. Now we can see that all the processes in here are of malwarebytes only. Good. The next thing that we want to do is to look after malwarebytes process which run DLL file, but the result of looking after the DLL file is not in a situation of success, but in a state of name not found. Just like we got here. So we are going to filter all the name not found processes of malwarebytes. So we'll click on filter again. I will choose result, just like here. Is, and now I will write name not found. And I will add it to the rule list. I will click on apply, and now we can see the difference. Great, now we can see each process which looked for any DLL or any other files, but the result was name not found. For a better look, I'm going to filter off all the registry results. For this attack, I'm going to use a DLL file called dwmapi.dll. This file is inside Malwarebytes directory on our desktop. And if we will check, we can see that it's the Malwarebytes folder we got on our desktop. This means that the Malwarebytes setup.exe is trying to run file called dwmapi inside its own folder, but it couldn't find it. That means that if we can create any DLL file called dwmapi.dll and put it inside the Malwarebytes folder, the Malwarebytes setup will run the DLL file. So for this, I'm going to take my own DLL file and rename it to dwmapi.dll, like we got in here, and then put it inside the Malwarebytes directory. I will close the setup and open it again. And we can see now what is going to happen. So here a CMD window just opened. And I will write net user, and we can see that the hacker account just added to the user list. I will write now net local group administrators, and we can see our hacker account is in the administrators group. That's all, and I hope you have enjoyed.